Okay,
shh.
Okay, ready? Here we go. I'm not gonna do it.
Come on, man!
Okay. Hello, all you fellow nerds out there.
Put a baby in me!
Hello, all you fellow nerds out there. Welcome to this week's session of Nerd Week Podcast. Be prepared for branters, ranters, spoilers, and ragers.
And a baby!
And a baby, obviously. Yay. There will be nerdgasms and other gasms.
On at least one or more victims.
Oh, God. This is like the best one ever.
I am your mom, Rogue.
Speaking of victims, I'm your host, Maya.
Firefly.
Dragon.
Mama Rogue.
Sexually frustrated thing.
Head dry in the blanket.
Whoa.
So earlier, she was sitting there, he was tickling her, and she kicks him right in the ball sack. And I'm just like, hey, if you wanted babies, quit kicking him in the ball sack.
I didn't exactly kick him there, I kicked around there, but he was tickling me.
It's called a love tap.
A love tap. Your children are already getting abused by you.
It was more of a warning.
Maya, he just wanted me to love him with my cold feet and his crotch.
And whenever you are tickling, whatever injuries you sustain is completely neutral. You
can is that very true?
You cannot hold a grudge against any tickle injuries.
Yeah. Full disclosure, though, I do not have a foot fetish, okay?
Bullshit! I do.
We all know what happens in the bedroom.
Careful what you grab, okay?
No, he's okay. He was tickling me. He was petting them. That's fine.
Petting your feet?
Ooh, yeah, he was tickling them. You
I'll
can
pet
like...
you later.
Ooh. I do not approve of this.
We were talking
already
about
this podcast has gotten
crazy. Your discretion is advised.
That's a little late.
This is NC-17,
we've already got the baby
okay?
maker blanket right here.
It has penguins on it.
We can make a blanket for it with this. Whoa. It'll be small, but we can make it work.
That's kind of kinky.
So what?
I'll piss the tent. Okay.
So hi. Matt and Aubrey can hold up the blanket. We'll just put a baby in me. We'll be good.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I thought we were going to do
and then we'll just wait 9 months for the processing and everything.
Are you kidding me? Aubrey has magic.
Yes. Yes, I do.
And then we have black magic.
No, that's ginger magic.
That's red magic.
You're ginger magic. I'm black
magic.
Yeah, she's black. You're ginger.
If we pop out a ginger
form. Yeah. Yaman.
Yaman.
Oh, goodness.
Let's get on with it.
Okay. Oh, my gosh. We are off to a beautiful start.
Okay, I'm going to change the subject.
Good.
Earlier today, I was watching the slow-mo guys.
Okay.
And they were pissing me off because of what they were doing. They were doing that swim cap challenge. Have you guys even heard of that?
Where you drop the swim cap on
yeah.
the head?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Some Japanese guys did it. We saw
that. Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah. Well, they were going to... They do it slow-mo, of course, and it was pointless for me to watch it because I already knew how the mechanics worked in behind it. But still, they were trying to do it onto the guy's face. And I'm like, that's not going to work. It's the face. I could explain it, but I'm not going to.
That's okay.
Because if I do explain it, I'm probably just going to be here for the rest of the podcast talking by myself.
Drawing up diagrams and play-by-plays and probably getting some dolls out and everything.
There's going to be dolls.
Where'd the man touch you with the cap?
What about Loki?
Loki.
Can Loki be involved?
No! Loki may not be involved. He's
evil, though. It's Loki. Loki. Ba-ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Something like that.
Good Loki.
He's got two horns. You don't want to mess with him.
You don't want to mess with a horny guy.
Then how do you fix his... Never mind.
His scepter?
Please stop!
You said don't mess around with the horny guy. Then he
Let's not
has
go
to
down
mess
that
around
road.
Himself.
Let's not go down that road.
Okay.
We're not going down that road. Anything else happened this week for anybody?
Saw The Flash and iZombie and Arrow. Those were all good.
I have a question.
We have a week off of school.
Yes.
We have a solid 10 days.
School's out for 1 week.
Doesn't capture me.
I have a question for iZombie.
What?
Yes.
Yeah. So it was like not this week, but last week. For anybody that watched it, you had the doctor guy who was telling Liv that. Sorry, I watched like half of the first season and the new season.
Because
he watches it and I can't just not watch it while I'm on my phone. So he was talking about like how they can't have sex or they'll turn Major into a zombie.
Right. Again.
Okay. So, well, yeah, I know he was a zombie. I just haven't got to that in season one, but I knew he was because Grant's explained it to me. But, like, the guy, the doctor guy had this little balloon puppet after he was talking about messing with condoms. Is it made out of condoms?
It was made out of condoms, clearly.
Yeah, I know. I was looking at it. I'm like, is that made out of condoms? And he goes, no, it's made out of rubber gloves.
Nope.
How would it be made out of rubber gloves?
That's what I was thinking. But the guy just made it out of condoms.
Yep. Because, like, the very long...
I want to know where he learned how to make balloons.
It doesn't matter. He made it out of condoms.
Why did he take the time to do it if he works in forensics? At a mortuary or whatever.
Why condoms? What else is he going to do?
I just have a question for that. So this guy sat there, bought entire boxes of condoms, and sat there and just was like, you know what? I'm going to make balloon characters.
Why not?
He's single.
I mean, if
man,
you're not...
Man, that's like... He's sitting there, he's like, strawberry.
Keep your fantasies to yourself, Maya.
I'd get the glow-in-the-dark ones and make sure it pretend it's a lightsaber.
That's a good way to start a gay porno.
That's it.
You would know.
That's how you start the gay porno. Lightsabers.
I see your Schwartz is as big as mine.
There we go.
Let's see how well you handle it.
Keep firing, assholes.
Oh, man.
I'm throwing my assholes.
It's Mega Mage. He's gone from suck to blow.
Okay, so Jessica Jones came out yesterday.
I watched the first episode. I haven't watched it yet.
Even though we love spoilers, I will spoil it for the audience,
but I don't want to be spoiled.
Fine, we'll do an aftertaste
on it.
It's okay. It's an announcement then. Just watch Jessica Jones. It's on Netflix now.
It's amazing!
Okay. What's Upon a Time?
What's
Upon a Time? When he pops up, I'm just like,
yeah.
I paused it, the doctor,
because he's in iZombie.
He was talking about how he dyed his hair.
And yeah, it's hilarious.
He keeps it that way because he's in iZombie. It was so funny. Be like, oh, Emma changed her hair. You know, it's okay, but I changed mine. Everybody puts up a big fuss. That's because you're a zombie.
Right?
Well, we don't know that.
That'd be interesting if they had some weird... sort of weird crossover.
Technically, he's
or
Dr.
They're in the same universe. That'd be weird if Once Upon a Time was in the same universe as iZombie.
That would be entirely possible.
I can see it. But it's interesting. He's a zombie in iZombie, or was a zombie now. Yeah. And he's Dr. Frankenstein in Once Upon a Time.
Yep.
Yeah. So it kind of fits.
That is interesting.
Because technically, Frankenstein's monster is the original zombie.
Besides voodoo.
Kind of.
Well,
yeah. Besides the voodoo
zombies.
He's
more of the modern, our version of zombie.
That is true.
How Americans perceive the zombie.
The animation thing. We'll see that more in Victor Frankenstein.
Yeah. Which I want to see so badly.
You like very much so. And then Hunger Games came out.
Don't tell me if you've seen it. I haven't seen it.
No. We need to watch it sometime soon.
We need to watch it. By the way, did you ever watch the Deadpool episode where I put that poster on there?
The poster?
Yep. it's the poster of Katniss sitting there, and then it's got Deadpool's mask over her. Oh, it's awesome. It's got Deadpool sitting right there, acting like Katniss. It's just like Deadpool. Well,
yes! Yeah. What about the other picture that's been running around on the internet for so long where he's got the blanket on him on the cape and the little ears?
I already put that.
That one's great. Where he's like
Say it! I'm Batman.
Nope!
Something I'm very interested in is going to be in the Deadpool movie. How many times he breaks the fourth wall?
I want to see how many
we'll
times.
We'll sit there and count them.
We'll count.
We'll
have a counter.
Tally them.
We'll be sitting there going. Mm-hmm.
And it's gonna go up high. I know it is.
I hope so, because
is that the point of Deadpool?
I think they'll start it off like that.
Yeah. We already know of one. He's like, please don't make the super suit green or animated.
That's like the first one.
That's the first one we know of.
Well, what about the part where he's like, you're going to help me hang out with less angry Israel O'Donnell? Isn't that breaking the fourth wall?
No, that's not breaking the fourth wall.
Making a comment about something else is not breaking the fourth wall. Breaking the fourth wall is talking to the audience.
Like we said, I'm going to touch myself tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah,
he's looking at the camera. He's just like, oh yeah, I'm touching myself tonight. That's breaking the fourth wall.
Yeah, okay? It is.
Because he's referring to the audience.
Yeah. He's talking to the
audience.
And when he makes a comment such as that, where it's referring to his own character in something else, that's
even
breaking
better.
The fourth wall.
Yeah.
Where he refers to himself as in a movie.
To express some rage.
Yep. That type of stuff. So I'm super excited for it. There hasn't been a second trailer for it yet.
Yeah,
and
no.
When is it due to come out again?
February.
Oh, okay.
February.
Not too far.
Next year, there's so many movies coming out next year.
Right.
What's the movie that you guys are most excited to see, as far as you know?
Oh,
it's
Batman versus Superman.
Okay. So here's the thing. It used to be.
And Suicide Squad.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Like, oh yeah, there's so many. There was. Okay, so there's Deadpool. Mm-hmm. There's Suicide Squad.
X-Men
Days of Future Past.
No.
Apocalypse. Sorry,
Apocalypse.
There's the other one that you just said. Batman vs. Superman. Now there's Warcraft.
Yes!
We have Warcraft coming out as well.
That trailer was so cool.
It was really cool.
They did really good with the orcs, too. I mean, they don't look like...
We will never be slaves.
The game orcs. The game orcs look like really... clunky, and they don't look like a race, if you ask me. But they did a really good job in the movie to make them look like what a real race would.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, subtle differences, not everybody the exact same, basically.
Have you seen any of the cinematics of Warcraft at all?
The most I've gotten with Warcraft storyline is when I was playing the storyline in one of the Warcrafts. The one where the paladin guy becomes the Lich King?
Yep, that's Warcraft
3. Okay, 3. It was 3. I thought it was
that's
3.
True.
I just didn't know.
So, you're going to have to watch like the World of Warcraft cinematics because you see the cinematics and you see why they're so good at the Warcraft movie. Because everybody has said for years to Blizzard, why don't you make a movie? Why don't you make a movie? And finally...
Your prayers have been answered.
Finally, after... billions of dollars of them making from World of Warcraft. Billions of dollars. They've dumped more money into the Warcraft movie than any movie out there.
Yeah.
Well, Avatar doesn't even cast a shadow over it.
They dumped a lot to make it.
That reminds me. They're doing Cirque du Soleil. They're doing Avatar.
That's right.
Really?
That looks so interesting. I want to see Cirque du Soleil. It's like the top tier of theater, in my opinion.
Have you seen, what was it called? I think it wasn't Grown Ups, it was Knocked Up?
They go to Cirque du Soleil.
They eat mushrooms.
That was great. Yay! Seth Rogen's all freaking out. He's like, ooh!
Daddy!
He's like, oh! Have you ever been to Cirque du Soleil on mushrooms? It's awesome.
And then they spend their time in the hotel with chairs.
And it's so many
chairs. This chair makes me sad.
So, do we have any news on the Assassin's Creed movie?
Nothing new. Just the same.
All we know is that Michael Fassbender is going to be in the movie. He's gonna play the assassin. He's gonna
Know anything about whether he's gonna be the first in first Assassin's Creed or if it's just gonna be a different story.
Right. We have seen a picture though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And we do know it's coming out more later, like in the fall of 2016.
Mm-hmm. So. Go ahead.
We need more info on it.
Yeah, we do.
Information.
What was it about that the Darkverse with Constantine, Zatanna, Deadman?
Oh yeah, I saw that.
Madam something or other.
I didn't even read it all the way through.
I saw it. It was basically a story where they're making a movie where they're gonna have five heroes: Constantine, Deadman, which is basically a ghost, mm-hmm. Zatanna. I'm pretty sure you know her. She's a magician also. Mm-hmm.
Zatanna is badass.
It's basically the DC world, but they're focusing on, instead of the Justice League, they're making it the mystical ones.
Yeah.
The mystical characters.
The mystic
League. The dark universe or something like that.
That's a good way to put it. There's Madam's something or other. It starts with an M, and she's basically a immortal voodoo divinator or whatever. And there's also Swamp Thing, apparently, that it's called.
Hmm.
And the guy that played Darth Vader, whatever his name is, apparently they're gonna Shut up.
Ren.
No. The movie Pacific Rim. The guy that played the shoes, the gold shoes. You know who I'm thinking of.
Yeah.
He's gonna be the voice for Swamp Thing.
Oh. Oh, you're the dad.
See? Yes.
See?
He's gonna be Swamp Thing.
Yeah.
Oh, you're talking about the guy that. Oh.
He played in Hellboy.
So Hellboy's gonna be in that.
Yeah, he's gonna be the Swamp Thing.
Yes.
And the TV Constantine. They wanted to do him for Constantine in the movie.
Right.
But they want to keep the TV verse and the movie verse separate.
So,
they're casting somebody new. They had two options.
Actually, really quick question: did you guys go to the guy's Twitter page to help support
Constantine.
Oh, I haven't done that yet.
I don't even have a Twitter account. I should do that.
I don't.
That's one of the few things I would do to support it.
Just share the tweet.
You share the tweet, you like it, and you just pretty much support it. You retweet it. Okay.
Spam
it like you can.
All right. So
spam it like you're supposed to.
So yeah, try and do it as soon as possible, as quick as possible, okay? Because I want to see Constantine
CW.
It used to be WB, so I don't blame you for that. It's CW now, though, for some reason. Like how Sci-Fi Channel became Sci-Fi.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Stop it! I'm gonna kick you! You can't make jokes like that and not put a baby in me!
This is
what's been going on all day, FYI.
All day!
If you haven't seen the bloopers, we gotta put them up.
Did you poke her in the bloopers?
They're not...
He poked me in the stomach and said, keep the oven warm! Why?!
Because she wants me to keep her feet warm, and I'm like, let's keep the oven warm too, then.
Wrong place, sir!
You guys, he's teasing me. It's not fair. I just want a cute little squishy baby.
Did you just say you'd squish your baby? What?
She said she wants a squishy baby.
Squishy baby. You know how like their cheeks are so squishy?
She wants a squishy.
And their arms are so squishy. Yeah, they're too squishy.
It's going to be an adipose. That's what it's
going to
be.
You guys are definitely going to have a fluffy.
That's what this is.
Yes.
Martin!
Odale!
Yes! Woo!
No? Yeah.
A couple days ago, I bought Aloha Fluffy. So it's him, Gabriel Iglesias, doing a live in Hawaii back in 2013.
Really?
Yeah.
I think our neighbors upstairs can hear us.
Don't care.
I love that!
Shh. That's rude.
Aaron.
Come on.
Yes.
No.
I just don't want them to come and bang on the door.
I should have brought my machete. Oh,
well.
Well, they just recently moved in, and I think that they have a kid.
They can only hear that.
Well, not only that.
That could be a table moving.
Well, that's true, but like, when they were first moving in,
can you hear anybody down?
And I'm like, are they Aaron, we can't hear anything. Butthead, stop banging on the floor.
Pretty sure there is someone down there, but we can't hear them.
Did you ever see that commercial where this girl, it's a band commercial, she goes inside this apartment, and she just goes, and a guy knocks on the door and just says, shut up! And she's like, nope, I don't want this apartment.
I don't think I've seen that, but that looks like a good commercial. Or
it's
like
a freaking hilarious
commercial. Yeah, that's how you it get the sense. Right for apartment.
It makes sense, though. You got to test it out in certain ways.
Ooh, ooh.
Something like that, right?
I think no? You failed.
Shut up, Matt.
You can't tell me to shut up.
Shame on you.
Shame on
shut
you.
Shut up, Aaron!
Shame. Shame.
No soup for you.
Hey, nerd
shame.
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 Shame. Shame.
I told Brandon, he shakes my face.
Sorry, I'm distracted right now.
See, these two don't know what we're talking about.
No, they yes. don't. He's shaking
and that shame. Gesture is not helping
they,
you any.
They don't know shame. What
he's shaking my feet because it makes my boobs jiggle.
You do realize that we got an audience here, right?
Yeah. Put a baby
Grant, in. You a-hole. Don't do that.
Bad
Grant. Boy. Bad boy.
Did anybody got a water bottle?
Yes, we need a water bottle for Grant. The thing is going to get a water bottle from now on.
But after, does but that after make he you puts a baby cat? Into Emily.
Does that mean you're allergic to yourself? Does that mean you're dead?
Oh my gosh.
Are you sad? Do you need a hug?
Not from you.
All right, give him a
put
hug.
My hand down there.
Give him a hug.
Give him a group hug.
Oh my god. Go. This is unorthodox.
Well, then be happy.
I am happy.
No, you're
be
not.
Be happy.
Okay, you can shake my feet real quick.
Yeah.
Wrong kind of happy.
It's okay, Aaron. You
if
can't tell if he's happy or not.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
If you're happy and you know it, shake your feet. Not that feet.
Now he wants you to shake my feet. I think he just likes seeing my boobs jiggle now.
I didn't see anything. I can't even see past there.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
We're in a dark area right now. Let's get out of this.
Let's swim out of
this
it.
This swim into the
Swimming Dory!
Finding Dory!
Finding Dory!
Do we even know what the storyline is in that?
No. I think she's trying to...
Yeah, she suddenly remembers something about her family, but at the same time she's trying to get back to him, but like forgets in part of it too, it seems.
I thought she got cured of her short-term memory loss in the first movie.
I know, I think
no, they were doing baby steps.
Things.
That's probably why she remembers her family.
Yeah. They're doing baby steps, so now there's going to be a big, big breakthrough.
It's like, apparently. Oh, you can remember P. Sherman 42 All Be Way City. Let's make you remember your family.
Yeah.
Oh.
Now, not only do we have Finding Dory, but we also got Kung Fu Panda 3.
Sweet.
Woohoo!
Yeah. With Bryan Cranston as his dad.
Yeah.
Bryan Cranston.
Yeah, he's going to play Poe's dad, or it's the voice of Poe's
dad. Hope you find your dad. Hope you find your
son.
And everybody is...
They're like, are you serious? You don't realize this?
Yeah. Right between the lines!
I'm excited for that.
I'll tell you what I'm excited for. The Incredibles 2.
Yes!
Yes!
Woo!
Heck that yeah. has been
have,
a long time
They better have
time
the original
waiting.
Voices of the
Better.
Actors.
No,
they should.
Well, as
Samuel
long as
Jackson,
Jack-Jack
definitely.
Is, as long as Jack-Jack is at least Dash's age in the first movie, I'll
obviously.
Be okay with it.
Be
well, because they have
but
to
he's
going to
be so OP, man.
Yeah, he is.
He's going to be so OP.
But who's going to be the new villain?
That's the good question. Maybe it'll actually be the mole.
No.
I doubt it, though.
They probably start the movie with them finding the moles.
No,
no, I
think that.
Well, maybe
the
end of the mole.
The game,
no, they'll probably
the
start out like how they
the
did with
thing.
The first.
Oh, okay.
Movie. They're probably gonna start out like how they did the first movie. Like,
yeah, that's what.
Instead
I'm
of
saying.
Like here, the golden age of heroes, it's gonna be the new golden age for the new generation of
there
heroes.
You go.
Yeah,
I can sure. see. I can see this as being like a, you know,
or like
all
more of
sudden,
an acceptance, but it's still a wariness of heroes.
Yeah.
But it's gonna be the newer generation.
and they get
young heroes coming in that are stepping in and coming into play,
coming into the spotlight for
and kind of kicking Frozo and Mr. Incredible and Elastic Girl kind of out of the picture.
That would be awesome, actually, because all of a sudden it's just like they're getting older, even though they're the family unit. They're getting older, and they're like.
Time to look at,
well, look and there's out. Like the young hero squad now, the young kids that are coming in,
and maybe even other heroes, love interests, especially for Violet.
I can't.
Violet
wait.
and Dash,
if he's old enough.
Well, and we have to have Jack.
We have to have Jack. At least talking.
Oh, he's gonna be.
He better be talking.
Honestly, if they do it right, it should be like 10 years. Hero. In the future.
Yeah.
So Violet should be graduated from high school. Maybe Dash should be about graduating from high school. And,
or trying to, anyways.
Or trying, to graduate from
Samuel
high school.
Samuel L. Jackson better be in it, too.
Yeah. Right.
Honey,
they're Disney.
Where's my super suit?
What?
Where is my super suit?
Why do you need it?
I need it.
Wow, don't be doing that, Super Darren, dude. We've been planning this for 2 months.
The public is in danger!
My evenings are in danger!
You come in with my stupid woman! We are talking about the greater good!
I am
your wife!
I'm the greatest good you're ever gonna get! Oh, gosh.
We probably don't move so fast.
Yes!
Speaking of which, what do you think they're actually gonna have names for them now? You know, official superhero names for the kids?
For Violet probably. And Dash?
At least.
Think that's their official names.
Well, I think I think Madam Mystery would be a good name for Violet, because she can go invisible, and it's not Invisible Girl, like, you know, Fantastic Four. Yeah.
Speed Devil.
Well, this is Disney, so
Speedy Gonzales.
Not really. Jack, we'll just call him OP.
Sounds fair.
The Oppressor. Now, I'm pretty sure they will, but I really want them to make a Wreck-It Ralph 2 movie.
Of course they are.
I love Wreck-It Ralph. It'll spend the shit out of that. So good.
But they'll probably introduce more games, like the newer games and stuff like that. Like more video games.
Hopefully.
Actually, I did want to go back to Incredibles for just one thing. All right. What do you think the villain could be, or who?
That's what I was actually going to mention. I think that they might start with the mole, kind of like see how they wrapped it up and finished him, and then they'll like have like a maybe a collage of events.
Montage.
Thank you. And it'll just lead to the next to the modern
just like
whatever
the first one. Yeah.
Time now, and then they'll make a new villain, and they'll have the drama of the life that they're in right now. That's how I think it would work.
I would like to be able to see an OP character that's Jack. Like that's kind of like Jack, but you know he's a superhero.
Well, I think that's where we'll tie that in, because where the superheroes had their children, so were the supervillains.
Mm-hmm.
There's
tons of supervillains that they could choose from. That it could be
like
their
who
children.
Says that Syndrome didn't have a son.
Pretty much anybody, because he's a nerd. True. Wait a minute.
Whoa, nerds have children. Not that nerd.
I know.
Though.
We're talking about the bad kind of nerds
the
that
guy
don't have children.
The guy was played by Jason Lee, one of my favorite characters of all time. He was he was in My Name Is Earl, and he was a professional skateboarder. I have mad
That's
respect
so
for Jason Lee. Okay.
He was also on Alvin and the Chipmunks.
And the Chipmunks.
He was Dave.
Well, his first couple of movies were with Jay and Silent Bob.
Yep.
That's why I have tons of mad respect for him. And he even said, I wasn't going to do this. I was going to be skateboarding the rest of my life. But all of a sudden, I just came in and did the part, and they wanted me. He wasn't expecting to be an actor the rest of his life.
That's what Johnny Depp and Alan Rickman both have said.
And Hugh Jackman.
It's true. Mm-hmm. And Russell Crowe.
And Harrison Ford.
Oh my gosh.
There's a lot of, a lot of these great actors.
And Bruce Willis.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure he did.
Well,
he used to be in a band.
Was he?
Yes, he used to do music, and then he went into acting after a while.
So, Die Hard.
Die Hard. Used to play Die Hard music.
Yeah. But so all these great actors.
That was a terrible pun.
Never even thought that they were going to have a career
we'll punish
in
him later.
Acting.
Yeah, we'll punish you later.
Just turn the orgy.
Barbara Dunkelman would sit there and roll over in her grave. Whoa, what's going on?
Oh, that is so weird.
Yeah, that ain't creepy.
Yeah, just coming in and just kind of shh.
I was about to say, where's my machete?
See, I told you.
So we had somebody walking through the door.
Just pretend I'm not here.
With that voice, that's going to be kind of hard.
Holy cat.
So,
hey,
yeah.
Wait, I have to ask the peanut gallery. Do you think I could have a kid?
No. Do you want to be an uncle?
They'd be too ugly.
Yes! Yes!
If they were your kids, they would be.
Oh!
But these two will make cute babies.
This is your niece or nephew we're talking about.
Well, they may be cute, but they'd be really short.
That is true. We're both pretty short.
But they grow really good beard, facial hair stuff.
And hopefully,
they would be well endowed.
Yes,
with some good graces.
Yep.
Yeah, well endowed.
We should.
Have you seen these?
Mine are still bigger.
We are recording at this moment.
All right, enough with the measuring contest. Let's get back to nerd work.
You're the one editing this, so it's up to you.
I'm not doing jack.
Jesse knows he'll win.
I'm not doing jack.
You are now.
Yes, you are.
Yeah, that's true. So what'd you get me?
Ooh. Oh, hey!
Yes! Pokemon, gotta catch them all.
The original, well, mostly.
No, those aren't the originals. Those are definitely
third generation.
Second generation.
It's Plusle and mine in.
Johto.
I got mine in.
Okay, cool. These are really fresh.
So,
because you're mining something very important.
So, I made this point before, but Pichu is the first. It's supposed to be Pichu, Pikachu, and then
Raichu.
Yeah. Right?
So, but they introduced Pichu till second JoJo series.
So when Pikachu sat there and said that Pikachu didn't want to evolve to a higher power,
he already has.
So Pikachu's being a total hypocrite.
Yeah.
But this was not realized by this time because they were just making this shit up as they were going.
It doesn't matter.
The writers didn't think it through. We'll just end it with that.
There are several shows where the writers did not think it through, like this current season of Castle.
Yeah.
Please don't ruin it for me. We're watching that right now.
Let's
just kind of go with. They're trying to recreate the wheel. With seasons 1 and 2.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Really?
They're trying to recreate the
wheel.
They're
trying to bring it back to where they have more views.
You know, speaking, who did do a good job of writing the entire series through? How I Met Your Mother.
Nope.
No?
We hate the ending.
The ending, yes. The ending sucks.
No, they did a terrible job. I'm sorry. I've watched every single season, and I hate it. Sorry.
Everything fits perfectly.
No,
no.
The beginning, the end.
It talks about
how
he met the mother, but you don't see the mother until the end. She's only in like 4 episodes.
And then she dies.
And then she dies.
That's
not
so
what
terrible.
I'm talking about at all.
That's so terrible.
I'm talking about the things that happen in the show that correlate with each other.
Right?
That's what I'm talking about.
I
and
don't
they,
care
and they go
about
back
that.
To things and they go. So remember when I mentioned
so
this?
Pretty much
yeah.
The
this
title
of
the show is How I Met Your Mother. Instead, it's How I Sat There and Lived My Life. That's literally what it's supposed to be called.
Basically,
My Life.
Or How I Hooked Up With Your Aunt.
That's how true. I Hooked Up With Your Aunt. That should be the actual title.
I don't even know why they went that direction, because it would have been great if they just ended it with them meeting, him meeting the mother and just...
That would have been great. Their
okay,
wedding.
So,
yeah. Their wedding and him going, and kids, that's how I met your mother. Cut.
Bam.
And
bam.
Done. That would have been like the perfect ending. But the whole, yeah, so your mother died and da-da-da-da-da. It's like, so this whole thing is actually about you telling us how you actually like Robin. Go
yeah.
marry Robin.
Yeah.
Yeah, that part I didn't like. I was surprised.
And
was
she still
annoyed.
Lived in the same place.
same dogs.
And the same condition with the blue French horn.
So and the, here's how this, I, here's how I would have done it differently, okay? This is just me personally, okay? Third season before they're going to end it, they introduce two female characters. Makes sense, right?
That would make sense, because then you're sitting there debating, is it this one or is it this one?
Exactly.
They come in and out. They don't have to be main characters. They could be, like, every couple episodes you have.
You can either have them as main characters or not main characters. Doesn't really matter. So long as there's some type of correlation that you don't know which one is which. You don't know which one is the mother. And then they finally introduce, yes, your favorite one, the one that you like the most. That's the one that was your mother. Yay! Good ending instead of your mother died. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, kids.
It's been a while.
You know.
Your mother's been dead for a couple years now, and I feel like it's time for me to tell this story of I got from
point A to point B.
Exactly.
I can see that. I mean, if
it makes sense, doesn't it?
It makes sense that he's telling the story to his kids because the mother died. I mean, it doesn't make sense that he's telling the story in the first place if the mother is still alive.
Exactly.
I want to hear her voice. They would kill her off, so to speak.
But it goes with Robin. He goes with Robin at the very end. It's okay, Dad. You can go with Robin. And we're it's cool. just like
they were pretty chill.
Did you guys just really do that?
Really, really chill about it.
They were
like, it's obvious that you like her. Go get her. And
you have to realize also when they actually filmed that scene. Years ago, before they even filmed season 10, that
because they filmed all those scenes with them sitting on the couch.
Yeah, they filmed all the scenes with them sitting on the couch before they filmed anything else, and then you know, with that ending in mind, and then that's what we ended up with. So
yeah,
and see, that's the thing with all those years of How I Met Your Mother, those two kids knew about who the mom was and how everything ended.
Well, they make them sign.
They couldn't tell anybody.
Yeah.
It was like the biggest spoiler thing that they couldn't tell.
For like 10 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
10 years.
That's worse. That's so much worse of something hiding like than Darth Vader and Luke.
No.
That right there, like 3 years of not revealing who Darth Vader is. Come on.
3 years?
Yeah. It's about 3 years in between.
They're baiting.
Wasn't it the second? Wasn't it five when he said, "I am your father"?
So there's the first one, which is the fourth one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Number four, episode four.
And then they were already George Lucas already had a script out, and he pretty much passed it out.
Yeah.
Okay. So the cast already knew the ending.
Yeah.
All the entire cast. They have to keep it a secret for 3 years while they're in production.
After that movie, they're like, finally.
And it's like people are talking about it. And it's a big thing in the movie industry. She would know. Once they sign something and they have to keep it a secret.
Solid. Yeah, but I read that when they were producing that particular scene, when he cut off his hand and everything, that Mark Hamill was told not to read a certain line.
Uh-huh.
And then when he actually said that line and he responded,
I don't think that's true, because like they have to read the entire script before they actually do their lines.
They do. They actually do rehearsals before they even start filming.
Mm-hmm.
They do. Might I just kind of pop in really quick? The way it was originally done was in the original script that was passed out. They said that it was Obi-Wan who killed Anakin Skywalker instead of Darth Vader being, you know, Luke's father. And originally, only three people knew. The director of the movie, Lucas himself, and the voice of Darth Vader. So they were James Earl Jones. They were the only three that knew about it until the premiere.
That's what I was trying to say.
Because they re-recorded that line in post.
Okay.
Because David Prowse was the guy in the suit, not James Earl Jones.
Yeah.
So David Prowse just kind of, you know, spat out random crap, and then, you know, everybody just kind of went with it. They went back and redid that line for when they recorded the actual lines for Vader. So.
Yeah.
That reminds me, have you seen the uncut
version? Yes, Lion King?
No, not Lion King.
Oh, sorry.
What the heck are you talking about?
I said, I'll tell you later. I gave you bloopers, baby.
Yeah, bloopers of the Lion King.
Did you see that?
I did see that.
I posted
that.
It on your Facebook.
I saw that.
Oh, it was hilarious.
It was just uncut of Darth Vader.
Check your Facebook, woman. I posted Butterbeer.
So pretty much, it's not James Earl Jones.
You have to make it.
It's just some random guy inside the mask, and you're just like, man, that's the Dark Lord? And James Earl Jones makes it. The voice. Yeah, the voice is what makes it.
Yep.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Thank you, James Earl Jones, for being such a very classy man.
Pretty much.
It's the voice and the music that they wrote for Darth Vader.
His
theme song. Those two things, that is what, otherwise it's just a guy in black.
Yep. But that intro is like, oh, here it is later.
That intro and then his voice, you're just like,
do not disappoint me.
It's pretty awesome. I'm glad they chose him for Darth Vader.
Oh, yeah.
So, Kylo Ren. We've only seen very little of him. Do you guys honestly think that he's going to make a good villain?
Yes!
So. Yes.
Okay, sorry. A little background information.
Kylo Ren,
yeah.
The new Star Wars movie. He's the new bad guy?
He's the new bad guy with the amazing lightsaber.
Oh, that guy. Never mind. I got it.
That looks like a training.
I never knew his name.
So, actually, I want to say something about this, okay? People have been complaining all over the internet. It doesn't make any sense to have those two blades out. Why do you think there's a fucking broadsword out there? God damn it! This guy actually did do a video on it. He put paint on a broadsword and had the two things out. And he's just like, let's see if I'm gonna cut off my arms. He does every move, not one mark.
Yep.
Not one damn mark. And people are saying, it's dangerous. The fuck is wrong with you?
If you know how to use a sword, it's not gonna be dangerous.
Here's the rant of the session right here.
Yeah, this is the rant. You guys suck. Sorry, you guys suck. And the fact is that lightsaber is the coolest lightsaber because it's also a fucking blaster, too.
Right?
He sits there, he does his deflection, and all of a sudden, boo-boo!
Yep.
Yep.
That's
Kylo Ren is going to be one of the coolest bad guys ever.
I cannot wait to watch that movie.
I don't give a crap what you all say. It's a cool lightsaber. Deal with it.
Since we're talking about...
That was, like, seriously, like, the best part of the entire, all of the trailers to begin with, is you see just the back of him, and then he stops, and bam, lightsaber.
Everybody on the internet did a whole entire
thing. Dude, the internet
thing.
Blew up when that first Star Wars trailer came
out. Oh, yeah, and everybody's just like, oh, we're gonna make, like, the lightsaber do, like, a tree and shit.
Yes.
And I'm just like...
Swastika.
Yeah, seriously. Swastika. They did all this different types of stuff.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, guys, come on. Seriously, it makes sense. Right. If they did a double-bladed lightsaber, if they'd done a single-bladed lightsaber, then why not?
Get creative. Come on.
Come on.
Now,
Darth Maul's lightsaber. Two of them.
Yeah, that was cool.
And he's sitting there flipping it around. No issues.
Yeah. But everybody's sitting there saying, oh, Kylo Ren's lightsaber is like the most ridiculous lightsaber on the planet. Fuck you.
It's more usable than anybody else's.
Don't pick at
I'm not picking at it.
So inside that video that I watched with the two things, he pretty much just said, you know what? With a single-bladed lightsaber, they're going to sit there and all he has to do is just move it down and you cut off a hand. That's it. Kylo Ren's lightsaber, you can't do that.
Nope.
It'll just, there you go. It stops.
That's true. That's true.
So, it makes sense, internet. Try.
Stop being so judgmental about everything.
You know I can't.
Try to figure something out.
I know.
Now,
you're okay.
Since we're talking about Star Wars, did you see this video that, I don't know when it was posted, but my brother showed it today. It's a theory, and I'm pretty sure it's in a joke sort of manner.
What?
Where Jar Jar Binks was a Sith Lord.
Yeah. He's the one behind it all.
That's why he did it. That makes sense.
I thought that was a funny video.
He's sitting there watching it and he goes, what? And then he goes, I can't watch this. And he just turns it off.
I mean, the video, for a reason. What they were saying in the video was pretty sound. It made sense. But I was like, there's no way that they would actually write him in as a Sith Lord and nobody even mention it or even him revealing it.
You know, that would be a really funny thing if that's like a funny F you to George Lucas's legacy. Basically, if somebody did that, it's just like all of a sudden Kylo Ren just takes off his mask and it's Jar Jar Binks.
That would be awesome. I would be so mad.
Oh my god.
That explains everything.
That explains the mask.
It's just like, I just took a dump on Star Wars. Here you go.
Okay, but here's the thing. When you have the mask on and he's saying those lines in the trailer, you don't hear him say, Misa gonna finish what you started.
That was
you don't hear him say that.
Therapy. No, that was him being acting as part of him being
stupid and clumsy. Acting stupid. Because
who actually, what was it, Scary Movie 1? They don't suspect the stupid guy to be the murderer.
Right? Well, like your dream with your friend. Yeah, I had a dream where, like, my friend, she's, like, really sweet and nice. She was killing everybody. And it was, like, a zombie. It was, like, after a zombie apocalypse, like, all the zombies were dead. And it was just, like, my group of friends left. And it was, like, this really sweet, nice girl was killing everybody off. And we're, like, okay, we got to figure out who the killer is. And we just didn't even think about her. She's, like, she's too nice. And then she was, like, cutting off body parts of people and storing them in a chest.
This dream just got more elaborate.
Oh, no, I'll tell you later. It was really creepy, and it ends with my friend playing video games, but it's like a different friend.
That's weird.
It was weird.
Complicated.
Oh, it was like...
It would require...
I told them the dream. Like, I sat them down. I'm like, I gotta tell you a dream that all of you were in. And, like, they're just sitting there like, you have pretty weird dreams. I'm like, yeah, I know.
Okay, have you guys seen the video where the guy who does Winnie the Pooh's voice reads Darth Vader's lines?
Oh, I think I have.
Oh, no.
It is the funniest. I will have to pull it up. It's so cool.
Yes.
Darth Vader is now Winnie the Pooh.
Oh, goodness.
Disney don't.
No.
Disney would.
They would.
They're a Disney superb. No.
They would, but they'd probably do it in, like, some random episode of, like, I don't know, Phineas and Ferb, yeah?
Yeah,
probably. They already did it.
I don't know.
But I'll have to pull it up. It is really funny to hear.
Now, the Star Wars Rebels.
So we're good.
Have you seen Star Wars Rebels at
all?
Not yet. I've only seen like clips of it, but supposedly, what's her name?
Ahsoka
is still alive.
Yes, she is.
She is.
So, are they actually going to kill her off? That's the question.
Maybe.
That's a 50-50 chance.
Jumpstart your titty! I need to go to bed.
Are you okay?
So,
wait, was he pinching his titties with the clip? Oh my gosh.
Uh-oh, here we go. What are you doing?
I'm hiding.
Hi. I'm very
sanity.
He's not going to do anything.
And my sanity.
He's harmless.
I'm not worried about him. I'm worried about all of you.
You should be worried about me because I don't...
Oh my gosh, this has been a long week. I'm so glad we're on vacation now.
What vacation?
We have vacation from school. We have the entire week off. I love it.
Yes, from school.
Yeah, next week.
School.
Yeah.
We have the entire week
I'm going to take
off.
That time to catch up on shows.
Yeah.
Be
love
lazy.
Me.
Love her.
Put a baby in me.
I have homework.
Wait for it.
So are we gonna do like the pregnancy test on the podcast?
No!
You want to record me peeing in a cup?
No, I want to record the actual positive or negative on there. That
Grant,
would be really funny.
You are you... not the funny.
Not this time.
Grant's like, oh, thank God.
And then we'll have another dad day.
Yeah, happy
but
not
that
Father's
mean
Day.
I wasn't
for this pregnancy test.
Do like every week. Weekly updates right here.
Jerry.
Right now.
Jerry.
Less man standing.
It's going to be like between all the podcasters.
That show.
I finished
just
it.
Like,
okay.
All right, you're not the father.
Yes.
Sweet.
But she's pregnant.
And it's going to... You're not the father.
I will tell you this now. You put a baby in me or I will find somebody that will. Bam.
Oh, shit.
Ultimatum. Right there.
That's a harsh ultimatum.
Is this you volunteering?
Maybe.
We'll talk later.
Okay.
Wow.
The three gingers are getting together.
Oh, goodness.
Well,
I have my options. Don't think I don't.
Just don't, you know, draw a star on the ground.
How do you think those gingers have sex?
Dude, come on. We gotta worship Satan.
With candles.
So next year is salt. So next year is 2016, right?
Yes.
So we just gotta make sure that the gingers don't get together and create a baby on
666.
666. Yes! Yes! Oh, she man. Knew where I was going with this. She knew it! Don't bring
my
in the
race.
Antichrist. Don't bring in the Antichrist.
You know what's really funny?
We'll bring in the Antichrist.
It is actually back in 2006, that 666, that day, was actually a really, really good day for me.
Me too.
It was actually a decent... Every Friday the 13th, they're always good days.
Yeah,
I have never had a bad Friday the 13th.
I had my bridal shower on Friday the 13th.
Yes, but good there talk. Was the attack yeah, in France on this
it was
Friday
fun. I got tons
that
of gifts.
That is true.
And that... I heard about that on that day, and I was really surprised about that.
Yeah. For those of you who haven't heard what has happened in Paris, which I don't see how you cannot.
Yeah.
Because
everybody's
didn't.
Posted on Facebook. Go look,
look
it up.
Facebook.
It's pretty tragic, and it's pretty bad. And
that's because
ISIS
of what?
Is
don't say nothing.
It's because of what?
You.
You.
It's all your fault.
It's all your fault. It's always your fault.
Yeah. Maya, shoo. No,
this
I mean, literally, go get my
this
shoe. Go get my shoe.
You're wearing your shoes.
I know. That's the point.
You know, my mom would sit there and throw shoes at me as a kid. She'd be like pulling it off. I'm going to smack you with the shoe. And then just
no,
chuck
mommy,
it at
no.
us.
No,
I got
so...
the belt as a kid.
Not the high heels.
Yeah, what is
kid? I got the belt as a kid.
Hand
and sometimes
belt.
The wooden spoon until it broke one day.
Wooden yeah. spoon. All right. All right. Punishment. Let's go.
Oh,
damn. You, your parents' punishment.
Yeah,
what was it?
I was
no,
laughed.
Mother's punishment.
Parents.
You have to,
well,
you
actually,
have to clarify with him. It is mother's
yeah,
punishment.
Yeah, my dad died when I was like a little kid, so, but that's beside the point. My mother told me that my dad would have taken me outside, pulled down my pants, and beat me with a hose. So I'm glad. But what my mom would do was mostly guilt trips.
Just guilt trips?
Mostly guilt trips.
Okay.
Occasionally, if I did really bad things, then she would physically discipline me, but that's beside the point.
Okay.
Yeah, you try.
So,
okay.
For me, when I was younger, it was the belt.
The belt?
And that was from my dad. And from my mom, there was some points where it was the wooden spoon until that broke. And then when I got older, when I was too old for like both of those, it was just getting grounded.
Grounded.
Yeah,
okay.
The took away things you actually cared about. That's what happened when I was older.
My
when
cabbages!
I was younger. When I was younger, my dad would use a belt or his hand. My mom would use a spatula. But, like, after she started punishing us for a while, we just laughed at her because my dad was scarier. And so she would
just,
like, just when your dad comes home, he's going to punish you because my mom is, like, really sweet. And we're just like, we can't take you seriously when you go to punish us.
Testify, sister.
Hallelujah.
Dragon.
My mother was the guilt trip. Still is the guilt trip. Let me just clarify that. And my dad...
was awesome.
My dad was a little more chill about things. I got smacked only a couple of times. But mostly because when my siblings would beat me up, he would just sit there and laugh.
Yes.
Yes, my children.
Wow.
Amuse me.
I would do that. I'd be on my throne sitting there going... Yes, children, amuse.
Calm down there, Zeus.
But you have to understand, my siblings are a lot older than I am, and they're a lot taller than I am.
Yep.
By a lot.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Tiny, and I kick their butt sometimes, too. And so
oh, I
it
still
was
kick
just,
my brother's butt.
It was just amusement.
Well, punishment on my part. It was only once I was ever used with the belt, because I broke a Winnie the Pooh snow globe. They stopped making those. Like, these are the very old ones.
Old, like the originals?
Kind of the originals, yeah. So my dad just had me sit in his room, got the belt, that was that. But every time we said, like, Mormon cuss words, like freak and all that stuff or crap, we got the lava soap. It's basically like really, really bad soap that if you had in your mouth would burn your mouth.
Isn't that unhealthy for you? They actually did a study on that.
They did, but didn't kids stop.
Oh, so that, I mean, hi.
That explains a couple of people.
Great! All right.
And no, there's that down there.
And those kids that suck on soap, but that's a different problem.
All right.
Did you eat pink chips as a kid?
Why?
Yes.
Sorry, continue.
So I've got three punishments, all right? My dad whipped me one time. Only one time. My mom mainly used a shoe. But this was the worst punishment of all time. Wasting.
This one?
Not this one.
This
one.
This little thing right here. Biggest punishment ever.
No, it's called time wasting. Okay? I found it to be the worst punishment of all time. Okay? So, my dad caught me.
Shut down!
My dad caught me kissing a girl when I was 15. Okay?
Okay.
So, what are you doing?
What do you want?
The bat.
Oh.
Oh my gosh! We're gonna let him go first, and then I gotta tell you something.
Okay.
Waste time wasting.
So
time wasting.
So I get back home at like 11 o'clock. Okay, I'm like on cloud 9 because it's my first kiss that I've ever had, and my parents caught me. Okay. Mind you, this happens all the time, okay? I go to bed, all of a sudden my dad wakes me up. And he's just like, you need to have a talk.
Oh, good gosh. Okay.
So, he talked to me from 11:15 till 6 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, no.
Those suck. My brothers did those to me. Yeah, my self-righteous brothers.
Yep. It's called time wasting, okay? And I have tested this theory. This works on children's punishment. My little niece, she was sitting there. She's just like, I don't want to play the piano. And so I'd sit there and be like, okay, you got to play the piano for 1 hour. And I put it on a timer. And when she was playing, I'd turn on the timer. And then all of a sudden when she stopped playing and started complaining, I'm like, that's 1 minute that you're wasting. That's 1 minute that you're not playing with your friends. That is 1 minute that you could have sat there and gone out with your friends and actually played with them. That's 2 minutes that you haven't done that you could have sat down and watched Dora the Explorer. I just sit there and just keep saying shit like that throughout the entire time. Oh, and she was getting so mad because it's like, to them, a minute is an eternity. To us, it's like, that's just a minute. Who cares?
Exactly.
So I feel that time is the worst. If you waste a kid's time, that's the worst punishment of all time. Of all time.
Yeah.
So that's what I wanted to say. Go.
Yeah, I was wondering why he was going like this. And
yeah,
I was thinking
it's
of
better
like,
to go like that.
Hero
that's a baseball bat.
Goes, Yatta! So I'm like, what is he Yatta! Doing? And then we're thinking he's other stuff. But my dad had this punishment. Which
literally
didn't.
The worst punishment.
It didn't last long, but I don't know why he made me do it.
A cricket
he
bat
had this
or baseball
nice
bat?
Metal. Metal? Ooh, bat. Okay, and we had to hold it above our heads.
Oh.
An hour. If our elbows went down at all, the
Dunk.
Time started over.
Oh, that's.
Oh, I know that. That was inside
so,
basic training. We had. They'd sit there and they'd give us our weapons and they'd be like this, and they'd be like, okay, it's only 8.75 pounds, privates. It's only 8.75 pounds, and we'd have to sit there and walk down the road like this, just. Yeah. Terrible.
Well, the thing was, is you can do it for a while, and I'd always make it, and the thing is we could not face the clock. It countdown, like, you know, put it on the microwave or something. I have to sneeze, sorry.
But
Banana. So you'd be holding it up, and the clock would be behind you, and you wouldn't know how long you were there. And so he'd make deals with us, because, like, I remember one time I'm holding it above my head, and I had to pee so freaking bad. At this time, I didn't pee every 20 minutes. I'm holding it above my head.
Wait till the baby comes.
Let's not start that again. So I'm holding it above my head, and next thing you know, I'm like, I have to pee. And he goes, I will let you go to the bathroom, but you have to start your time over. And I'm like, fine. I put the bat down. I had 5 minutes left. I was so pissed.
Oh.
I could have waited. No, I should have just pissed myself.
That would have been punishment for your dad. That would have been hilarious.
I peed myself.
Look what you did.
Darn it. Dad. We were like making fun of you because you had a button undone. She's like, he has a button undone. And I'm like, do you want me to fix it? And she goes, no.
Oh, yeah, I've got great friends.
We have to call it. So.
Yep, we're at time.
So, until next time, nerds, troll, and I'll troll you back. I'm Maya.
I'm Firefly.
Dragon.
Mama Rogue.
I'm the Thing.
Carrot Top.
You're not sexually confused.
Frustrated. I'm frustrated. Did you just say he's sexually confused?
Yes.
Go
yes,
correct him. Though. If I was sexually confused, I'd be cuddling up with Matt here.
Point proven. Point proven, right there. If I was confused, I'd be cuddling up with Matt.
You're right there, bitch.
Gosh.
I guess they just want to cuddle us with us gingers.
You're not getting your soul back.
Doesn't happen.
Bye. See you guys.
Bye.